Eric Yee Lin. He worked at 343 for 8 years. He worked on Halo Infinite. He worked on the Slipspace engine. He loved his time working there and made a 15-minute video basically trying to get people into the gaming industry, developing games. And then gaming journalists took one line out of a 15-minute video and said Halo Infinite's gonna suck, and they crunched their employees. They also went on to say that Halo Infinite is not gonna be the original vision and that working there has been a shambles. The poor guy comes out with another video saying that's not what I meant at all. First of all, they translated it from Mandarin, so obviously if you Google Translate stuff, it's not gonna be accurate. And then the people behind this, when people corrected them about it, they just started blocking each other on Twitter. I was flabbergasted when I read this. Eric was so genuinely distressed because he was worried it would impact his future in the industry. He didn't want people at 343 to think that he was smearing them, and he didn't want future employers to see like, oh my god, this guy might be a liability. So he put out a second video clarifying it, but he said when he reached out to the gaming journal and saying, look, you guys have got the wrong idea, they ignored him. So guess what? I'm doing a video about it because I feel like his voice should be heard. He seems like a really nice person. So let's go through what he said and see what he actually meant. Now, gaming journalists have had a pretty sketch history in my books, especially when it comes to Halo. There's been a lot of posts. The most notorious one in recent times has been the April Fool's Day, where these bunch of Halo memers made a fake Twitter with a fake tick for verification on Twitter and said Halo Infinite is gonna be delayed till 2022, and Kotaku ran with it. Didn't even bother to check the Twitter, just ran with the article straight away without vetting their information, just for clicks. And then they had to rescind and backtrack because they were wrong. All they had to do was click on the Twitter account, check how many followers it was, and verify their source. Hell, they could even just personally message one of the employees and say, is this an official statement? It would have taken 5 minutes. And yet, they still didn't do that. Then you got PC Gamer, who are making information about Halo MCC, and they use a Halo 5 Warzone picture. What are they doing? These guys are professionals. It is their career to report on gaming news, and they can't even do that right. Not only that, you got a guy who literally had his stuff taken out of context, and he's reaching out, and you purposely ignore him? What are you doing? I went and read up a follow-up article that these guys finally printed about 3 or 4 hours ago, and in that article, I'll post it on screen now, they insinuate that he's only saying these things because 343 has gotten to him. He doesn't work there anymore. So let's get on to what he actually said. First of all, the crunch. This is the most important thing. He even says this is the most important thing, and it's the thing that upset him the most. Basically, he said when he was working there and his creative juices were flowing, his words, that when he was on the grind and he was in the zone, he would just keep working and kind of lose track of time. He was passionate about what he did, and sometimes it equaled working for long hours. And this is while working at home, by the way. This isn't working in the office, obviously, because of the pandemic. Everyone was working from home at 343. But it said it really upset him that they took one line about him working really long hours, and they stretched it into a full article saying that 343 mistreats their employees. It really kind of puts into perspective that outrage gets clicks. Because the fact that this has blown up, lots of YouTubers have covered it, they'd be relishing. They'd be so happy that they're getting all these clicks, views, and attention. Because frankly, I don't think they really care where the viewership or the traffic is coming from as long as they're getting the views. They don't have a like to dislike ratio on Twitter or their articles. It's sensationalized. And it really seems like with all the pressure on 343 for Halo Infinite, that's a whole another video. I could do a whole video about Halo Infinite, the pressure on it to succeed, the lofty expectations that the game has. I do not envy 343 in the position they're in with having to deliver such a huge product after a long hiatus, 6 years between titles now, and the expectations of us as a community when the game comes out. Next up, he spoke about his time at 343, and he said he had a really pleasant time working there. He didn't know everyone there, obviously, but he really loved his time there, and it really upset him again, because he's friends with these people. You work, you're co-workers, you work with them for years and years. 8 years is a long time. That's longer than you're in high school. He was genuinely concerned that these people who he considered friends, colleagues, were gonna resent and hate him for things he didn't even really say. The fact that they translated from a different language, didn't get the translation completely correct, and the fact that English isn't Eric's first language, I think Mandarin is his first language, it's really just straight up unfair what they did to him. You can probably tell, because I usually make commentaries and I'm really chill, relaxed, and just talking about stuff. I'm fired up about this. I don't get fired up very often, but with all the leaks that have been happening with Halo Infinite, game journalists and other companies knowing that it's such a hot topic at the moment, we're about a month away from E3. Any news scrap And some of the leaks I've read, which are completely outlandish, set expectations so damn high, almost unrealistically high, that when we actually see the game, and it's not what they expect because of the expectations built by these journalists, that's just gonna keep on building up the hate. They're gonna be like, oh, we expected this, this is what we heard as a leak, and we didn't get that. And they can make more negative articles. It's a sensationalized cycle to get clicks and traffic from the gaming community. I guess that's media in general. A lot of media is sensationalized. A lot of media is like, oh my God. But when you take what a guy says out of character, out of context, with absolutely zero disregard of how that's gonna affect him, not even as a person, but as a professional, that's out of line. So what can we do about this? I'm gonna link his videos in the description below. I'm not going to link the article because I don't believe they deserve any sort of traffic whatsoever for what they've done. But I've noticed a big outpour of support from the whole Halo community for Eric. So I wanted to make this video showing my support for him because I thought it was unfair. And I just wanted him to know that I personally support him. I'm sure you guys do as well. With how anxious he said he's been over his future in the gaming industry because of this whole debacle. Eric, if you ever watch this video, it will all work out. That's the best advice I can give. It might be a hot topic at the moment, but with the amount of support you've had, professionally, I'm sure people at 343 would highly give you a recommendation wherever you go. And you have a whole community backing you. So thank you all for watching. Go check out Eric's video in the description below if you haven't. I got lots of content on the way, guys. I could probably do why do I love Halo? Why do we love Halo as my next commentary video, because I really want to do that. But thank you all for watching. Hopefully you all enjoyed it. Let's hope gaming journalists actually get their sources and facts straight before they post stuff. And thank you all for watching.